The Kardashev Scale imagines all kinds of advanced and futuristic civilizations. It's a popular way to think about everything from technological progress to the search for extraterrestrials. What's perhaps a little disappointing, though, is that it's generally agreed that we humans rank at just 0.7 on the scale only. We're still a long way from reaching even Type 1, the next level above our own. But today, we're not just envisaging the next step up. We're soaring to the very top. This is Unveiled, and today we're exploring what everyday life would be like in a Type 4 civilization. Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. When the Kardashev Scale was created by the Soviet astronomer Nikolai Kardashev in 1964, it was originally built around three types or levels, known as Type 1, 2, and 3. These are markers of sorts, indicating the level of technological complexity and advancement of any given civilization, based on the amount of energy it can use. A Type 1 civilization can harness all of its own planet's energy. A Type 2 can harness the energy in its own star system. And a Type 3 can capture and use the energy content of its entire galaxy. At the time, it's said that Kardashev himself thought that that was the limit. Held back as we are by such physical constants as the speed of light, a Type 4, with the energy potential of the universe, should be impossible. In the time since Kardashev's day, however, Type 4 has become a widely accepted concept, and something of a bonus level to the original model. Still, the first thing we can say for today's video is that living in a Type 4 civilization would generally mean living in a world that's far beyond our current physical understanding. Among the presently impossible inventions and abilities available to a Type 4 are a means of breaking the speed of light, possibly via wormhole technology, and a means of time travel. As we've found in previous videos, time travel isn't technically impossible, and traveling into the future, at least, is theoretically quite easy. Although there is danger posed by various paradoxes, a Type 4 civilization would have to learn to live with those paradoxes. But it's perhaps a fair price to pay, given the trade-off that they'd also be able to bend the universe pretty much to their will. Everyday life might involve, for example, moving from planet to planet, or even galaxy to galaxy, in the name of work or leisure. And all while potentially moving up and down your own timeline, too. But significantly, a Type 4 being would probably take for granted their ability to do all of that, much as we've grown accustomed to our modes of transport, like cars and planes. So what would actually happen at such a heightened level? A Type 4 society will have naturally discovered all that the universe has to hold. So where do they go from there? Would they still have a purpose to work towards? Living at such an advanced time might sound like it'd be a blast, but would that truly be the reality? Jobs are impossible to predict for a future this far away, but some are perhaps more likely than others. Most jobs as we currently understand them will have been automated, taken on by machines that may or may not be fully conscious. But one industry that's sure to be booming is energy. With a universe's worth of energy to manage, there'd be plenty of roles available. Automated or not, energy workers would be much like power plant workers today, except they'd be gathering energy from the universe's most violent events, draining quasars, absorbing supernovae, and filtering dark energy from the rest of the void would be just some examples of the employment that might be available. All across the universe, there'd be engineers and mechanics tapping energy, as well as those charged with storing it in reserves and distributing it to the rest of the cosmos. Although again, it's difficult to imagine organic humans as we are now taking up the task. Instead, workers would be full, or perhaps partly, robotic. Organic humans in general could well be a thing of the past at this point. A cyborg revolution is so often predicted for us in the future, but for a Type 4 being, it will have happened long ago, in their ancient past. First, they'll have embraced artificial body enhancements as part of their earlier rise through the Kardashev Scale, equipping themselves with purpose-built, replaceable parts, designed to be as tough, reliable, and efficient as possible. Bodily functions would be out too, with workarounds devised so that things like sleeping, eating, and going to the bathroom simply aren't necessary. But what's more, by the time of a Type 4, the changes will have most likely turned to the brain as well. Transforming a Type 4 being's thoughts as a hive mind replaces the individual. This would be a key development in the bid towards collective consciousness, a seemingly inevitable step for any civilization with universal power. As such, would a Type 4 being have a home to speak of? if we're imagining humans advancing to this point, then we'd most likely have forgotten about Earth long ago. Even if it was somehow saved from a red giant sun, we'll have moved on, and might not even be based in the Milky Way galaxy at all. Thanks to our Type 4 enhancements, surviving anywhere would be so simple that we'd probably never even consider that it had at one time been so difficult. Home, then, would be everywhere, with the universe connected as succinctly as the continents of Earth are now. One moment you're chilling on Venus or the Kuiper Belt, then you're in a whole new star system, like New Scorpii, a distant place with seven suns. And then, you're skirting the edges of a supermassive black hole somewhere, without a care in the world or universe. Because by now, even black holes are under your control. Rather than an endless mystery, as it is now, the universe is your playground. Every star, planet, and object is known about. Every creature is discovered, cataloged, and part of the collective, which again is all powered by boundless energy. In one version of Type 4, it could be that new stars, planets, and creatures are continually created by Type 4 beings as well. So absolute is their control over all things. Or perhaps even the task of creation has been offloaded onto automated machines by now. Regardless, in our minds, a day in the life of a Type 4 is essentially a day in the life of a god. And even something as massive as the universe becomes more like an ongoing project, something to work at and balance, but also to enjoy and explore. The less advanced creatures within the universe would certainly have an opinion of the Type 4 power watching over them, for better or for worse. But what's doubly strange, and perhaps a little unnerving, is that there may still be other forces that are equal to or even above this level of advancement. If the universe is actually but one part of the multiverse, as some theories claim it is, then there should be other Type 4s out there, presiding over their own realities. Perhaps there is a physical space between them that neither can breach, or a temporal one as part of the possible invention of time travel. Either way, it could mean that even Type 4 would be striving for improvement, with their eyes set on becoming a Type 5. Here, there would still be at least one shared purpose, continuing to drive civilization forwards. But in most other aspects, it would seem that a Type 4 existence would be one that's wholly fulfilled from our point of view. Today in the real world, we grapple with such here-and-now problems as climate change, space travel, population growth, and the general pursuit of happiness. But a Type 4 being doesn't bother itself with such trifling concerns. And if there is only one universe, then it really has achieved the absolute maximum that any group can ever hope to achieve. The potential downside is clear to see, however, and the question of where do they go from there remains. Through the lens of human history, after exploring one continent, we took to the seas to find more. Upon exploring one planet, we've looked to the skies in search of other worlds. But when a Type 4 looks at the whole universe, it sees something that's totally known and thoroughly tamed. If reality were a game, then it's one that a Type 4 has completed, with every trophy won and every side mission navigated. You might imagine that an overriding sense of boredom, listlessness, or perhaps even hopelessness would set in, with the rest of time stretching out before them. But then again, in this inorganic, robotic, relentlessly efficient version of life, an advanced enough being could probably just reach inside themselves and turn those negative emotions off with the flick of a switch, before jetting off to another corner of their universe in search of something new. So it's not all bad. And that's what everyday life in a Type 4 civilization would be like. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments. Check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.